You know, with today's weakened economy, could this actually be a good time to start your own business? The answer actually may be yes. Mm. Joining us now with practical business advice are the founder of Craigslist, Craig Newmark, and the author of The Accidental Branding, How Ordinary People Build Extraordinary Brands, David Vinjamuri. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Good to see you guys. Welcome.
So, the audience, welcome to you too.
There you go.
Could this really be a good time to start a business? I mean, credit is tight and people aren't spending much money these days. What makes this a good time to start a business?
It wouldn't be a great time to borrow $1 million and get 30 employees in a big building and start a business. It could be a great time to start a business in your basement. It could be a great time to start a business where you're solving your own problem. It could be a great time to do something that doesn't even necessarily make you leave your own job.
Mm-hmm. More specifically, I mean, what kind of businesses do well? I mean, what particular businesses should people be thinking about in particular?
Well, I think the best way to think about starting a new business is to think about solving something that exists in your real life, a problem that you experience yourself, because then you know there's a market of at least one
right.
for it.
Right, right, exactly.
And the chances are that also means that there are other people who have the same problem and that you'll be able to connect to them.
I want to hear Craig's story, because we've all visited Craigslist. How did you get started?
Basically, I was at Charles Schwab, you know, in 94. I was evangelizing the internet. I saw a lot of people helping each other. So in early 95, I just gave back a little mm-hmm. by telling people about what I thought were cool events, arts and technology stuff. From there, I just listened to more suggestions and did something about it, listened more and did something about it, and that pattern continues to this moment.
So I guess it's about coming up with it, as you said, with an idea for a service or a product that you would use.
Or maybe even a passion if it's not too mm-hmm. out there.
Yeah, absolutely.
What's the best thing about owning your own business?
Well, in our case, what feels right about it is that we're doing well by doing some good stuff for people. Mm-hmm. That's pretty satisfying.
And the biggest challenge initially, what was that?
The biggest challenge was my own, well, frankly, as a manager, my skills are limited, and it took me a while for me to get out of denial.
Craig demoted himself.
Demoted himself?
Sometimes you have to
do that. You delegated authority to other people?
Well, fortunately, I hired a guy named Jim Buckmaster as CEO.
Yeah.
He's a full foot taller than me, and I recommend you get yourself a giant CEO.
Let's offer some tips to viewers at home who want to start their own business. I know one of the things you recommend is do sweat the small stuff.
Right.
That's contrary to the conventional wisdom.
So, and what I mean by that, I spent time with Craig and seven other entrepreneurs who had built these huge businesses, including mm-hmm. Gary Erickson from here in the Bay Area who did Cliff Bar. And I found that they were incredible perfectionists. And the reason it matters is that people, it has to, whatever you're doing, whatever service, whatever product, it has to work, right?
Right.
Or nobody will be interested.
Right, right.
But it's the little details that actually make people delighted. And yeah. that's what made these businesses really
you
work.
You find
well.
All these cupcake places now that are doing such great business.
Yeah.
It's because they're special. You know,
exactly.
It's the details.
That's exactly right.
You also say pick a fight, which I think is hysterical. I want to see what that means.
Well, and you know, Craig is a great example of this because you know that you have a great business when you really disagree with the way somebody's doing something.
Sure.
And I think your whole career, and more specifically in Craigslist, you've really disagreed with the way things that were done before and the idea of giving people a break.
Well, that's part of what we do. As far as I could tell, one of the key reasons for any success we've had is that we do believe about treating people like you want to be treated.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And we try to follow through with that every day, which means customer service.
Right.
As soon as I get home, that's what I do.
Mm-hmm. And you advise that you become your own customer. What do you mean by that? Expand on that.
Well, what I mean is that you don't really know what people care about if you're not the customer for it.
Mm-hmm.
I spent 18 years in big companies. I was at Coca-Cola as a brand manager at Johnson & Johnson, and I was always researching what other people thought. And when you're the customer, you actually know. And none of these entrepreneurs did hardly any market research. That's what's amazing to me.
I think a lot of people who start their business get very discouraged when it is not a huge success right away. You say be unnaturally persistent.
Yeah. They go at different rates, but Burt's Bees took 22 years to get to $100 million.
Wow.
I mean, and Roxanne Quimby, who I spent some great time with in Maine, talked about the fact that the first time she sold products, she made $200. Wow. And she was thrilled. She thought she had become a business legend.
So you can't become an overnight success. It's just a long overnight.
Exactly.
Overnight is not
it
just
arrives and suddenly say they say, wow, it came out of nowhere.
Well, all of these tips are on our website, so do visit the website. Great to have you guys here. And it's uplifting to know that even in hard economic times, we can still start our own business and have the prospects of success.
All about having some hope.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.